Hello everyone, welcome to the TSS. In this class we will discuss about the box plot. Friends, a box plot is a categorical distribution plot. We already saw that in the last classes, last introduction class to a categorical distribution plots. So this box plot is very much used to detect distribution of data points, friends, and the outliers particularly. So let us see the code, a box plot. After writing all the routine codes of loading the data set, setting the plot background and the plot size and the plot title, we should call the method called box plot method from the Seaborn library. And here also x is a categorical variable, that is day we are supplying to the x-axis, and y is numerical variable, the total bill is a numerical column which we are supplying to the y-axis, and then data we are passing the df as a variable to the data. So these are all very simple code, friends, and the diagram shows. You need to understand the diagram properly. That is the main point. The codes are very simple, but understanding the diagram and getting the insights, what data is telling, that is a very major step in the exploratory data analysis, friends. Data visualization concept is for extracting the important insights from the data. For that purpose, all these graphs are useful. These plots are useful, friends. Okay, so let us switch over to the Jupyter notebook. So here, just I will copy and paste it. Okay, SNS dot sets, style white grid, plot figure. I will give box plot of x is equal to day, y is equal to total bill, and data is equal to df. Okay, so let us run it. Okay, here it showed up. Okay, this is the box plot, friends. This is the box plot. So let us analyze the things now. So day on the x-axis, total bill on the y-axis. Day is a categorical variable, y is the numerical variable. So let us analyze by taking the Thursday. So on the Thursday data is distributed like this, because this is a categorical distribution plot. So it will plot the distribution of the data. So on Thursday, total bill is heavily distributed from say some 11 to 20. Okay, so this box, you need to understand this box plot. This is the minimum starting, this is the minimum maximum. Let us understand it by calling df of total bill, total underscore bill describe method, so that you can describe. This method will describe the data which is available in the total bill, friends. Okay, here you can see count is 244. That means 244 entries are there. The mean of the total bill is 19. The mean, you can I think you know the mean is the average, the the sum of the values divided by the number of values. Okay, and it is a standard deviation. This is the minimum. Okay, the minimum of the total bill available in the total bill column. That is 3.07. That is the minimum. Okay. So that is the minimum for all the days, not for particularly Thursday, for all the days. And 25%, this is 25% mark, this is 50% mark, this is 75% mark. Okay, and this is the maximum. Here these are all marked as the lines in the box plot, friends. Okay, so this is minimum. The minimum is marked here like that. This is what I am showing is for all the days. If you extract the things for the Thursday, it will come to the Thursday only, the total bill. Extract the total bill and we are describing it. So like that, if we analyze for Thursday, only for Thursday, we have a minimum, maximum, and the 25th percentile, 50th percentile, 75th percentile, and the maximum. So this is the minimum here. Okay, and the 25th percentage line is this one. Okay, this one, this is 50th percentile, this is 75th, and this is the maximum. But there are outliers here. So these are the outliers, but that is called the special ones, which are other than the common distribution out there. You need to handle these outliers properly in order to draw the important insights, friends. Okay, so if you take the these outliers into the consideration and analyze the data commonly, then you can lead up to the errors. So you will always need to handle the outliers properly. And then the Friday is also, this is the minimum value. This is the 25th percent value, 50th percent value, and the 75th percent value, and then this is the maximum, and this is one outlier there. All those boxes are like that only. Okay, quartile, 25th quartile, 50th quartile, 75th quartile. Quartile is the term used in the box plot, friends. Okay, so it will explore the distribution, the maximum distribution area. Okay, so this is all about box plot, friends. And in the next class we will see the other plot called violin plot, friends. Till then, bye bye. Yours Veera, signing off. Thank you for listening.